Medical devices on the Health Watch tonight as the government and manufacturers try to ensure the safety of things like pacemakers. Some are wondering if they're doing enough.
Let's give you more on that now with health reporter Stephanie Stahl.
Yeah, some concerns about this one, guys. We are talking about implanted medical devices that help keep people alive. But because they're controlled by computers, they can be hacked. So theoretically, someone could interfere with how the devices work.
Billy Rayos and Jonathan Butt say they have no trouble hacking into medical devices.
We've yet to find a device that we've looked at that we haven't been able to hack.
The two security researchers have examined critical machines like pacemakers, drug infusion pumps, and insulin pumps, devices that help keep people alive. They found all have vulnerabilities that would allow someone else to take control of the machines because the devices are run by computers, and computers can be hacked. One example, they sent a wireless signal telling an insulin pump to deliver the wrong amount of insulin to a patient nearby who might be wearing it. Or, with a pacemaker, a hacker could reprogram the device from anywhere, disrupting a patient's heart rhythms in a way that could hurt or kill them.
There's no coming back from some of these exploits, right? So if a pacemaker for a patient gets hacked, you can't take that back. You can't issue them a new credit card. You can't tell them to change their password. You can't issue them credit monitoring. They're hurt. They're killed.
Any device can be hacked, and that's often not understood.
The FDA's Dr. Suzanne Schwartz oversees medical device cybersecurity. She says manufacturers have been playing catch up.
It's a culture shift. So the actions and the activities that we're seeing manufacturers take are very encouraging. They're very promising. But we still have a ways to go.
Now, companies that make medical devices are working to improve security, mainly with new encryption technology that's basically encoding data so that only authorized parties can access it. We're also told that patients who have concerns should check with their doctors or also reach out directly to the manufacturers.
Sure.
You know, this is scary stuff you see on TV. We don't have evidence this is happening anywhere. So, you know, people don't need to get too worried about this, but it can happen.